Catherine Knight asks, do you have nutritional suggestions, markers, or tests that might be relevant to improving SI joint pain and dysfunction? I'm 60 and looking at steroid injections as a next step as my sleep and ability to exercise has become increasingly compromised. I also seem to have sulfur sensitivity, sulfation issues, so I'm working with that constraint as well. Perhaps related, perhaps not, I have vitamin D SNPs, and at least a couple of years ago was over converting my D. Well, not having seen the older data on over converting your D, I do wonder whether that's either an autoimmune issue or it reflects something else with vitamin D metabolism that is leading to some moderate hypercalcemia. And so that right there makes me wonder whether the joint pain and dysfunction is more a factor of autoimmunity versus calcification of the joint. So certainly if it's autoimmunity, I'm thinking you might have problems with folate. You might want a low folate intake. You might benefit from having more AND. You might benefit from removing hypothetically pro-inflammatory foods. Whereas if it's a calcification thing, then I think you want, you know, good fat soluble vitamin nutrition. So you don't want to go too high on D, but you do want enough D. You need to get A and K2 in there. Magnesium is important. Acid base balance is important. Citrate is probably helpful. Magnesium, if I didn't already say that a minute ago. And then on the sulfur issue, molybdenum and manganese are both important for properly dealing with sulfur. And then you might also want to be looking at your gut microbiome as well. So I think short of molybdenum deficiency, generally people who are sensitive to sulfur often have gut issues that are driving production of hydrogen sulfide and or sulfite in the gut. All right, hope that helps, Catherine. Thank you for your question.